Hiya folks, Phil here, and very happy Sunday to you. Welcome to my very first cigar review. If you're familiar at all with my channel, I've been reviewing pipe tobacco and nasal snuff tobacco for quite some time now. I do smoke cigars on occasion, but I've never reviewed them before, but I thought I'd give it a go, just as another little sideline here. I am a complete rank amateur at this, so please keep that in mind when you're issuing your critiques to me. I mean, you know, everything I do is kind of homemade here from this very dark garage I'm filming in to my, you know, this is one of two humidors that I keep. It's a Tupperdor. You know, you got a Tupperware container. It's pretty airtight with Boveda packs. I tend to use the 69% Boveda packs. This one is a bit full. And I, you know, cut with a simple V cutter. I light them with matches. I don't have all the gear, the accompaniments, the accoutrements that you might find in a more polished presentation. But hopefully that's all part of the charm. As I say, cigars are a rarity for me. Once a week at the very best. More like once a month. But in the warmer weather, I tend to prefer them. So today I'm going to do one that... still here in the cellophane. Today I'm going to do a Camacho Candela. So Candela's a green wrapper. I mean, it's the same. It's like a Criolla tobacco. It's cured differently, Candela. It's sort of cured early, flash cured, so the chlorophyll still remains in the wrapper, giving it that sort of green tinge. If you ever watch old episodes of Columbo, you always smoke the green cigars. And these come out once a year around St. Paddy's Day. Although not every year they've come out, but it's a 5x50 ring gauge and a very pretty bright green festive wrapper with a little silver shamrock on the bottom. And I recently got a couple of these. I've smoked one already, and I thought I'd just sort of take you through it. This is going to be heavily edited as I get there. But so let's just begin, shall we? I'm going to cut it. I like these V cutters for me, because when I used to have the guillotine cutters, because I'm not very good at it, or I bought two cheap ones, occasionally I would tear up the cigar. But I find with these V cutters, I can always... This one's not really driven by how sharp it is. Well, it is a bit, but I mean, when this, I paid like £2 for it. And when there goes, it goes. So in the US, I think you could pay $7 or $8 for one of these. In the UK here, I probably paid around £11. You can't... It's very difficult to find reasonable cigars here for under a tenner. But there's a few I've got, and I will take you through them, because I think you'll... The ones that I like, anyway. This is just my palate, of course. You might completely disagree on my take on this cigar, and that's absolutely fine. And what you might find is over time is like, our tastes are somehow the same. So what I like is what you like. And you found, and there's a few reviewers out there that I think, oh, if they like it, I'll probably like it. Or I've even found the opposite. One or two reviewers out there, if they like it, I'll hate it. And the opposite usually appears. That's fairly rare. Okay, let's get into it. I'm going to light it. And I'm going to come back. You don't need to see me light a cigar. I'm sure you're all quite capable of doing that yourself. So I'll see you in a sec. So the cigar itself, these are Honduran cigars. These Camacho cigars. And the cigar itself is pretty nice. It's a little spongy. Except right in the middle. So I don't know if that means that it hasn't been particularly well wrapped. Oh, it's not packed full of tobacco like other ones. That's all I could really say about the wrapper. It seems to be wrapped quite nice. I don't see a whole load of veins and all that sort of stuff. And, you know, if you're spending good money on a cigar, you want it to look good, right? The whole ritual of a cigar. You know, spending that extra bit of money. So the wrapper is mildly sweet. It does remind me of green tea. And the smoke is really creamy. A bit of wood there in the middle. Hint of nuts and a hint of cream. The actual tobacco inside, I think, is a lot stronger than this wrapper implies. This wrapper, because it's mild tasting, slightly sweet, kind of herbal. But inside, you've definitely got a nice medium. Medium strength bit of tobacco. And a bit of cream and nuts and cedar wood mixed with that sweet herbal wrapper. You know, certainly makes for a nice smoke at the beginning. I'm not getting spice or tingle, that sort of thing. It is quite smooth. A little hint of molasses sweetness there. There's a lot of spice in the retro hail. My nose hairs tingle away. I suppose that's probably going to be the case with most cigars, but they really did. Whoosh. I'm going to come back after I've taken this wrapper off. I'm not going to do the first third, first half, unless it dramatically changes between the first third and the middle. So back for one last round. I'll see you in a bit. And I'm back. And I've just gotten about the halfway stage. Burned a quick bit quicker than I thought it might. I've just taken off the band badly. Tore everywhere, but hasn't damaged the cigar at all. I think it's burning quick because of the sponginess, I would say. It hasn't really gotten any stronger. Still very pleasant all the way. If anything, it's smoothened out by this sort of point. It's probably only taken, to the point I lit it to the halfway point, 15 minutes, and I'm not puffing away or anything like that. Would have hoped for a bit of a slower burn. That real spice I was getting in the retro hails. Very minimal now, so it's all smoothened out. I'm drinking this with a cup of tea. And it goes together pretty well. Very silky, nutty, creamy, woodsy. That's probably all you could say about a lot of cigars, but it's on the sort of medium. It's on the high end of mild, the right dead center of, you know, low, medium, high, mild, that sort of profile. Hasn't blown my socks off in terms of nicotine or anything like that. The draw is really, really easy. Not too easy. But again, I think it might have something to do with this sort of the fact that it's not quite as packed as I would have expected. Voluminous smoke. Because I'm a pipe guy, and when I see that much smoke, I'd be, whoa, you know, but I know with cigars, it's different. That wrapper is very tasty. I just want to kind of put my tongue on it when I'm smoking. Get a little bit of saline, sort of salt. Just a whisper of it every once in a while. I can't say it's a big, booming salad of complexity. It's just, it is what it is. Medium cigar, some tasty wrapper, in my opinion. Burns a little quick, but you know, it's not on the high premium scale of price, so balancing those two together, but the flavor is lovely. It's pleasant. I really enjoy it. It just doesn't change. It doesn't get stronger. In fact, I think it gets a little weaker, but not by a lot, other than that rough edge of spice and tingle, which I never picked up on my tongue, but I just picked up in the retrohale. It's either that or I've gotten used to it. So I'm going to rate this on my scale. As I said, I was going to do the cigar daily type journal where you write all these things down and subtract from 100. And I'm not going to do that. Okay. I have a 5-point scale that I use for my pipe tobacco reviews that I'm going to carry on. So let me explain what the numbers mean. So 1 means throw it in the bin. It's not for anybody. 2 would mean it's not for me. Personally, but I recognize it's probably good for a lot of people. 3 means it's about average. I could take it or leave it. Probably not going to go out and buy any more, but I've enjoyed what I've smoked.4 means, no, I really did enjoy this a lot. I want to buy more. And I want to chuck them in my humidor. Really like these, you know. They're going to become a firm favorite. And then a 5 is, these are outstanding. Sell your mother. Sell the house. Buy what you can get. Okay. So, you know, given what this is, there's a novelty bit with this Candela wrapper. Well, I do like these Candela wrappers. As I have to say, there's a novelty element there. The price is reasonable. probably good for somebody who's just getting into cigars or strong, stronger tobaccos. You don't have to sit here and analyze it. It's just a decent smoke. It's not so cheap that you want to cut your grass with it either. You might want to sit down with a bevy and some pals and shoot the breeze. I'm probably going to give this about a 3 in it. It's slightly more than average, slightly better than average for a medium cigar. I'm going to give it like a 3.2. I won't be desperate to go out and get these again, but if I came across them, I'd probably pick up a couple more. That's my take on it. And as they come out once a year or whatever, you don't have to go insane to find them. They are out there. They are out there. Just not at the moment in the UK. They were before, not now. I hope you got something out of that. I just enjoyed doing it. I wanted to smoke a cigar, really. So, that's all I've got for you. I'll see you again for a chat. Or a pipe tobacco review, or a nasal snuff review, or a cigar review. I hope you can join me again. Thanks very much for spending some time with me. Bye.